Hello friends, welcome to the channel Solution. In this video, we will discuss about the analytical balance. The whole video is divided into three parts. In the first part, we will discuss about the parts and its function. In the second part, we will tell you how to set and arrange the analytical balance. And in the third part, we will discuss about the different steps involved in balancing the analytical balance. Now, start the first part of this video, the parts and the function of analytical balance. This instrument is analytical balance. You can open the right side door by rotating the knob provided over it. Similarly, you can open the left side door. You can open the right side and the left side door at the time of loading and unloading the pen, and also at the time to set the analytical balance. But always remember that at the time of measurement, make sure that all the door must be closed. You can also open the front door by lifting it up. The all working part of the analytical balance, as you can see, is enclosed inside the glass fitted wooden case so that at the time of measurement it will not be disturbed by the air or any other thing. Now the next part is the balancing pen. This is the left side balancing pen with hanger. On this left side balancing pen, we have to keep the substance to be weighed. This is the right side balancing pen. On this right side pen, we have to put the standard weight in order to measure the weight of the substance. These two pens are suspended from the stirrups. This is the left side stirrups, also called the suspender, through which the left side pen gets suspended and provides support to the pen. And this is the right side stirrup through which the right side balancing pen gets suspended and provides support. These two pens hang through each of the stirrups. This part is called plumb line. It consists of the small weight with pointed end suspended through the thread from the central beam. This plumb line is aligned with the lower point to ensure that the balance is set and it is perfectly vertical on the horizontal plane. These two nuts are provided at the base to support the pen at rest position. This is the pointer which moves over the graduated scale, and this graduated scale is attached to the central pillar. This pointer is fixed vertically downward direction from the beam support, and this beam support is present on the upper part of the analytical balance. This is the beam support. This part is called knife edge. There are two knife edges pointed in the upward direction on which the stirrups set. This is the right side support over which the central beam rests when the analytical balance is not in use. This is the screw called balancing screw provided on the central beam. You can rotate this screw in outward and inward direction to increase or decrease the weight of the right pen. This is the central beam over which you can see the scale called rider scale, on which we put the rider at the time of measurement if required. There is a 10 division from the center zero on the right side and 10 division on the left side from the center zero. In the middle of the beam, you can see another knife edge facing downward and provides support to the beam. Similarly, there are two knife edges on the left side also, on which the left side stirrup set. This is the left side support for the central beam. And this is the left side balancing screw. You can also rotate this in outward and inward direction to increase or decrease the weight of the pen. This is the knob provided on the right side. You can pull this knob to set and move the rider on the rider scale. Now, the second part of the video is about how to set and arrange the analytical balance before using the balance. Place the stirrup with the two points on the right side of the balance over the two supporting knife edge perfectly, and then place the stirrups having the single points on the left side of the analytical balance over the two left side knife edges perfectly. After setting the both the stirrup, place the balancing pen with the two points and hang it through the stirrups having the two points on the right side of the analytical balance. After this, similarly, hang the left side of the balancing pen having the one point through the left side stirrups having the one point. Now, the analytical balance is perfectly set and arranged. Now, in the third part of our video, we will tell you the steps of balancing the analytical balance before doing the measurement. In the lower side of the analytical balance, you can see a knob. This knob is called arresting knob. To check whether our analytical balance is balanced or not, turn this knob clockwise gently and completely. You can see that the central beam gets lifted up from the rest position. Now see the pointer movement. If the pointer oscillates equal on the either side of the central line zero or the pointer remains at the zero mark, it means that our analytical balance is balanced. Now see the pointer. You can observe that the pointer shift more towards the left side direction from the central line of the scale. This means that our analytical balance is not balanced and we have to balance it. Here the pointer of the analytical balance shift more towards the left side. It means that the weight of the left side pen is lighter than the right side pen. So we have to increase the weight of the left side pen to make the weight of both pen equal in order to balance the analytical balance. Turn the knob anti-clockwise to lower the central beam and to bring it into the rest position. Before setting the pointer, first we have to set the plumb line. We can observe that the pointed end of the plumb line is not aligned to the point of the knob fixed to the pillar. This point should be exactly aligned over each other to ensure that our balance is in the perfect level on the horizontal plane. For this, adjust the leveling screw provided at the base of the analytical balance, the right side, left side, and at the back side of the analytical balance. Rotate the leveling screw in the clockwise or anti-clockwise direction so that we can move the balance in upward and the downward movement till the plumb line align exactly over the point of the knob fixed to the pillar. Now you can see that the plumb line is point exactly over the pointed end of the fixed knob. It means now our balance is perfectly set on the horizontal plane. After setting the plumb line, now we have to set the pointer. For this, again rotate the knob. Now you can see that still the pointer shift more towards the left side. So we have to adjust the balancing screw. Now open the left side door, rotate the left side balancing screw on the central beam in the outward direction, close the door, and then again turn the knob clockwise slowly and completely. After the complete turning, you can observe that the pointer again shift more towards the left side. It means the weight of the left side pen is still lighter as compared to the right side pen. So again adjust with the balancing screw. Again open the door of the left side and then rotate the balancing screw in the outward direction slightly and again close the door and again turn the knob completely. Now you can see that the pointer remains at zero. It means our balance is now perfectly balanced